Hi, I'm Rosie Golan for Herb Music on Alex TV.
Zusammen. Hier ist die Roxy für euch, für Urban Music, und neben mir sitzt heute die bezaubernde Rosie Golan. Rosie, hello.
Hi, how are you?
Welcome to Germany.
Thank you.
Welcome to Berlin.
Thank you.
One thing that you're looking forward always when you're in Germany is, this is what I read.
Ah! Oh my
Some
god,
nice
that's
gummy
amazing.
Beer, so,
thank you.
Yeah, we're going to record the show tonight. Let's have the audience watch the first part, and we can, have some gummy bears, some
thank you.
So, wir machen es uns hier gemütlich. So,
you can thank you.
Wir machen es uns hier gemütlich und wir machen es uns hier gemütlich und ihr schaut euch mal den ersten Teil des Konzerts an mit Rosie Golan. Bis gleich.
Thank you.
When you hear it, but you just don't listen. When you're looking, but you just don't see. When you're thinking there's no rhyme or reason, think of me, think of me. When you're getting to the end of a hard day, and you're thinking it's a long way. When you're thinking that you're just plain crazy, 'cause you're on your own, think of me. I will find you, I promise. I will make you believe. Oh, that I'm in this crazy love for the long haul. So think of me, think of me. Driving on an empty highway, you're surrounded by the sky and the sea. When you're seeing such a thing of beauty, do you think of me? Think of me. If I make you a promise, that's a promise that I keep. And I'm in this crazy love for the long haul. So think of me, think of me. And I'll be home soon, I'll be home. I'll be home soon. Oh, cause if I make you a promise, that's a promise that I keep. Oh, and I'm in this crazy love for the long haul. So think of me, think of me. Yeah, I'm in this crazy love for the long haul. So think of me, think of me.
How you guys doing? Oh my goodness, you're so excited. Hey, Udo.
Udo.
Everybody say, Udo. Okay, so how are you guys doing? Okay, all right, I'll take it. I'm so excited to be back in Berlin. I love this city because I live in Williamsburg in Brooklyn, and I feel like we're kind of sister cities. I look around and everybody looks like they could live in my neighborhood, so I feel comfortable here.
You've got the loudest power, but you've got no bite. It's a funny sight to see. Like a paper tiger hanging on a string. Darling, you don't bother me. You're like the foe. I can never lie out of my shirt. Sometimes I wonder if it is worth it, taking all that you throw at me. You've got the loudest spark, but you've got no bite. It's a funny sight to see. Like a paper tiger hanging on a string. Darling, you don't bother.
So, da sind wir wieder. Die Rosie Golan sitzt immer noch neben mir, ganz gemütlich neben den schönen Kamin. Rosie, you're playing tonight in Berlin, yep. In a Bergheim-Kantine.
I'm excited.
This is so cool. This is such a cool place.
I've heard a lot about it. Yeah. Apparently, it's got a lot of history behind it.
Mm. Yeah, next to us, the Bergheim Club, one of the most important and hottest clubs in the world.
Maybe they'll let me in later after the show.
Maybe. Yeah, but I wanted to talk with you also about you and your music. And I read a story that you started doing music on a very unusual way. With 19, you bought your very, very first guitar.
Mm-hmm.
What was this about, or why with 19? Why not earlier?
No, I don't know. You know, I didn't know that I could sing, and I'd never tried writing a song, and I'd never had access to a guitar before. It was just a very random thing. I was in the car and I heard an advertisement for Guitar Center for sale, and I just decided to check it out, and it worked out. I don't know, many years later, but yes.
And you walked in and just bought a guitar.
Well, I walked in and I put a deposit down because I couldn't afford the guitar. And so they said, if you finish paying it in 1 month, you can have the guitar. So I went back and, you know, kept working, and I saved up, and then I took that money and I bought the, you know, the guitar. And that was it.
And then you started to sing and started to write your own song, or did you start to cover first songs of others?
No, I wrote my own songs from the beginning.
From the beginning.
Yeah. I had a neighbor who was a musician, and he taught me three chords. And so I just kind of played guitar for nonstop for like 6 weeks, and I wrote my first song. And then I went to an open mic. I don't know if you call it the same thing here, but, you know, you can go to a place and you sign up and everybody takes their turn, like, playing one song. And it was very scary, but I loved it right away.
Okay.
Yeah.
And now you're not scary anymore.
Sometimes. You know, sometimes I get nervous, but for the most part, no. I love it so much. Yeah.
I also read that you have a very interesting mix in your blood. Your mother is from Morocco.
Yes.
Your father is from Romania.
Yep.
You were born in Israel.
Yes.
And you grew up in how many countries or which cities did you live?
I lived in Frankfurt.
Oh.
For 6 years, actually.
So how is your German then?
It's terrible. I used to be fluent in German, and somewhere along the way I lost it because I wasn't practicing. You know, when I was growing up, I didn't have anybody to speak German to. So I don't speak it anymore, but I've been trying to learn while I've been here. I'm picking up, you know, words here and there.
So you can order a beer or a tea or...
I actually can't order a beer yet, no, but I'm counting a little bit, and I've learned like a few, you know, sort of key words. Sometimes I'll just ask people, oh, how do you say this, or, you know.
Gummibärchen, for instance.
How do you say that?
Gummibärchen.
Gummibärchen, yep.
Okay. Sounds good.
Awesome.
So Frankfurt, Israel, Germany, Israel.
Yeah, Frankfurt, and then Netanya in Israel, and I also spent a lot of time in Paris and in Budapest in Hungary. And then I moved to the States, to Los Angeles, and now I live in New York.
In Brooklyn?
Yes.
How is that?
I love it.
You love it there?
Yeah.
So I've heard Brooklyn is like the Berlin of
it is. That's the thing is, you know,
the US.
being in Berlin, it's actually really comfortable because it's a lot like Williamsburg in Brooklyn. A lot of, you know, lots of hipsters, lots of artists, lots of different cultures and people from all over the world.
But all those cultures you've been through your whole life, did they somehow influence you and your music?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think that, you know, your whole life kind of influences you up until the point that you start writing songs, and everything that you've been through is going to end up in that, you know, whatever it is that you express.
But there was no moment in your life where you thought, now I have to start doing music. I mean, actually, you were sitting in a car, and then you decided to buy a guitar, so something must have happened.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was like a really big change in my life. I was living in New York, and September 11th happened, and
okay.
So I came back to Los Angeles, and I just decided I needed to figure out what I should do, you know? So there was definitely, like, I was on the edge of trying to see where my life was going. So
19 is also an age where many changes are happening in
my life. Yeah, exactly. So I went for the most stable thing in the world.
The most stable thing in the world, music.
Music, yeah.
And it's very nice that you decided to go for music. Das ist total schön, dass sich die Rosie für Musik entschieden hat, denn sonst wäre sie heute Abend nicht hier und wir könnten diese schöne Musik nicht genießen. Lass uns wieder mal reinschalten zum Konzert. Viel Spaß und bis gleich.
Just when I thought I hadn't seen a thing, you went and promised me we'd float. Promenade through all the little corners of the world that no one knows. Climb Mount Everest, build ourselves a terrace, overlooking Isle of Wight. But suddenly skies are darkening, clouds are rolling in, realizing all the while I've been strung along, carried by a lead balloon. Oh, but how could I have ever left the ground? Pulling my way is you. out you crossed. I start dreaming of rooms without a ceiling, buildings towering applause. If only we could drift as though we were filled with helium light as feathers. We would never come undone, cause darling, we'd be tethered. I've been strung alone, carried by a lead balloon. Oh, but how could I have ever left the ground?
Thank you. So today we've been on tour for a week here in Germany. And I love this country. It's so beautiful. I lived in Frankfurt for 6 years when I was a kid. And so I was once a fluent speaking German fluently. I spoke German fluently, but sadly I lost it along the way. I didn't have anyone to practice with, but that's okay. I'm making up for it now. I'm learning lots of words on tour. One of them, being my favorite, is Scheiße. It's just fun to say, but it's especially fun to whisper. The next time you get really angry, if you just go Scheiße, it'll relax you. I promise. It works for me.
Let's all try it together, maybe?
You guys want to do it? Just, yeah? Okay. One, two, three.
Scheiße!
That was... Doesn't that feel nice? Feels really good.
We'll have to try that again later.
Yeah, if you get really angry.
You definitely didn't say Scheiße. It's okay.
Circumstance are all knotted up in the start of us. Open eyes, open wide. But if it happened once, it happened. We sat down and spoke about all the ways that she did on to fall, drenched in talk, untangling thoughts that we had out loud from the inside out, and my could burst wide open when you arrived from nowhere. There was nothing out as you and I, you and I. Oh, this came out of nowhere. There was no one out as you and I. Our skin on skin, and I read out loud all the things I love. We fell asleep, our bodies we tucked away underneath the sheets, and your heart felt like it could burst wide open when I'm not afraid to die.
Thank you.
Immer noch neben der zauberhaften Rosie Golan in unserem schönen, netten Interview. Rosie,
yes.
Actually you're quite famous in Germany and no one knows it.
Really?
Yes, you are, because I figured out that you're writing a lot of songs for others.
Yes.
And in Germany, a huge star is Lena Meyer-Landrut. Yeah? She is like our big, big star because she won the Eurovision Song Contest. Mm-hmm. 3 years ago?
Yeah, I think it was 3 years ago.
Yeah, and actually you wrote for the first show where they had to decide which song to take. Mm-hmm. One of the songs was from you, B. Then the year after, again, one song was from you. And now her new single, Stardust,
yep. Is
also written by you.
Yeah.
How does that feel, hearing your songs that you have written sang by others?
I love it. I think it's really wonderful, you know, to kind of write songs and see other artists perform them, and she did a really amazing job with Stardust. I'm really happy. I think that, you know, it was a really good collaboration. I love the song. I love what she did with it, and so I think it's good.
And some of the songs are also then on your album.
Yes.
I Like You is on your album.
Yep.
On Lead Balloon, and it's also on Lena's album, on her second album. Do you listen to this different kind of interpretations of the songs? Do you like hearing your songs being interpreted completely different?
Yeah, it's fun. I mean, of course you want to know sort of what people did with it and where they took with it, you know, where they took it. And I've been really lucky. Like, I've loved every version of the songs that have come out. And yeah, I don't know. It's really fun. You know, it's a whole nother creative outlet.
But don't you somehow feel that it's a little bit unfair that people like her who do not really write the songs getting the credits?
I think that everybody has their place, you know, and some people their strengths might just be performing, and some people, their strengths might be just songwriting, and some people can do both. And I know that Lena also writes. So, you know, I think for her, it's probably both. I don't know. It's just sometimes you cover people's songs, and I kind of look at it that way, you know? I don't know. I don't think it's unfair. I think it's wonderful, and I'm glad to be involved in that part of it as well.
Do you also sing songs that others wrote for you, or maybe not for you, but you like them so much that you decided to sing them?
I've done a few covers, you know, live. I haven't recorded a cover yet.
Okay.
But I have done, you know, a few covers of songs that I just really love, and, you know, I'll interpret them live at shows.
You also collaborate very often with other musicians. I saw you in the summertime in the Postbahnhof, where you were there with some other nice musicians, where you, sang
along.
We
did the songwriter circle,
This was really nice. But I also saw you with William Fitzsimmons.
Yes.
This was really nice. How do you decide, or how is the process? Do you then just decide, oh, let's do a song together? Or how do you write a piece of music together with someone like William Fitzsimmons?
Well, William and I have not actually written together. He was a guest on my record and sung a duet with me, which was wonderful. But I have collaborated with a lot of people. And I don't know, you just, you know, you kind of, the music industry is quite small. And after a while, you get to know different writers and different artists. And you have people that, I have people that I work with as well that say, oh, this person's really wonderful. You should check out their music. And maybe you would like to collaborate with them. And for me, it's really inspiring because you kind of get like a fresh take on music. Every time you meet somebody else, they're going to inspire something new in you. And sometimes it's nice to just write alone as well.
Are you going to sing some of the songs that you wrote for others, like for Lena, or that you've been performing with William tonight?
Maybe.
We'll see. Lass uns mal schauen.
Have to wait and see.
Vielleicht sich eins dieser schönen Songs auch in die heutige Show einschleichen wird. Viel Spaß beim nächsten Konzertteil und bis gleich.
If you stay, I'll sing you to sleep. I will say words of flame, words that keep you warmer than you allow yourself to be. If you stay, I'll sing you there. If you lay your head where my pulse is, feel the blood map its way through the veins round our bodies, and something keeps us breathing while we sleep. If you stay, I'll sing you there. For nothing can change this. Gravity does its thing and pulls us near. Where our machines find a place they're meant to be. If you stay, I'll sing you there. So darling, come closer, closer. Darling, come closer, closer.
Ready?
Where are the seeds? We'll find the place they're meant to be. If you stay, I'll sing you to sleep.
Good job. Thank you. You guys are awesome. How did it feel getting in team with each other?
You are.
Was it good for you? It was great for me. So, So I've been coming to Germany for a while, not just to play, but I also come out here to write sometimes, and a few years ago, I had the pleasure of having one of my songs in the Eurovision Song Contest, and really lovely young singer called Lena won that year, and she recorded a song that I wrote, and a year later, same thing happened, and now there's a new song on the radio called Stardust that Lena sings that I co-wrote with a friend of mine in Los Angeles, and I thought I would play it tonight. I might fuck it up. I might not. Hopefully I won't.
I might fuck it up.
He might fuck it up.
I haven't played this before.
He hasn't. You're right.
But I do like it a whole
Don't
bunch.
Make me nervous. But anyway, so yeah, so this is Stardust.
We've been waiting for the sun. So we go to sleep. star dust, invincible, we're jumping off the edge, reaching for the moon, living every day. Covered in stardust, invincible, we're jumping off the edge, reaching for the moon, living every day, invincible like old.
So, does anybody here know who William Fitzsimmons is? Yay. He's a really lovely singer-songwriter, so talented, and he comes out here a lot to Germany to tour. He's got a große Bart. It's my other two words that I've learned this week, and that's it. I've now used all of my German on you. I was lucky enough to have William sing on my first record, and he sung this duet called Hazy with me, and tonight Alex is going to sing it with me.
I watched you sleeping quietly in my bed. You don't know this now, but there's some things that need to be said, and it's all that I can hear. It's more than I can. What if I fall and hurt myself? Would you know how to fix me? What if I went and lost myself? Would you know where to find me? If I forgot who I am, would you? Hurt myself.
Also ich hoffe, so weit hat euch das Konzert gefallen. Es geht natürlich gleich noch weiter. Ich habe aber noch ein paar Fragen zu, über das aktuelle Album, was Rosie Golan herausgebracht hat. Das heißt Let Balloon. Rosie, your current album, your second album actually, Let Balloon. It's a very, very nice album. Very singer-songwriter-ish, a little bit folky, a little bit country. How would you describe the sound
like
of
that.
It? Yeah?
It's kind of a mix of, you know, a little bit folky, a little bit poppy, a little country, and I don't know what we call in the States Americana. It's kind of, you know, all over the place, but in a good way, I think.
Yeah, Let Balloon, the title sounds like, two different things. Let, something very heavy, and a balloon, something very light. And I have the feeling that this this differences continue on the record from the lyrics, from the feeling that you have when you listen to the music, from sadness to happiness. Why do you sing, or why do you decide to catch all those differences into, even one song?
It's not really a conscious decision, you know?
It sounds like a plan for me, or even like a concept.
Yeah, no, it wasn't at all. It just kind of, I just did what came naturally, you know? And the way that I write, I just write songs that I love, and then, you know, I kind of collect them, and then eventually I go, okay, I have this record, and these songs all feel like they fit together. But it wasn't a conscious decision. I didn't go, okay, Lead Balloon, and then I'm going to put sweet melodies over sad lyrics or anything like that. But I do see, in hindsight later, how that all kind of came together.
But how did you write it? Do you prefer to sit on your own at home next to the fireside?
I wish I had a fireplace. Yeah.
Writing your songs, or do you write on tour, letting inspire yourself from everything around you?
I travel a lot when I write. I mean, I wrote a lot of this record in Los Angeles, and in London as well. So. A lot of the people that I collaborate with are both in Los Angeles and in London. I tend to go away when I write, to go somewhere outside of home, and I don't really write much on tour.
So you need like your quiet place and...
Yeah, definitely space, but also somewhere different just to be inspired.
And you're staying with this, with your sound, or are you going to, I don't know, develop into a new direction?
Maybe, we'll see.
Electronical, I've been thinking about it. Boom, boom, boom.
Yes, I'm going to start techno.
After your visit to the Bergheim.
Yes, exactly. I'm going to go clubbing, and then I'm going to just change directions completely and scare my mother. I don't know. I feel like I want to do something different. I'm just not quite sure what it is. I know that whatever I decide I want to do, I want it to come naturally. So I don't feel like if I try too hard, it might not come out the right way, you know?
What's also very interesting about you is that your songs are used very, very often for TV shows. You're like the next Amy Mann or something like that, because her songs are also
She's
used
amazing.
Very often for TV shows or for movies. How do you feel like when you're watching, I don't know, Private Practice or one of those TV shows, and you suddenly hear your voice singing?
Well, I actually watch Private Practice, so that's really cool. I love it. I love it when it's a TV show that I really love to watch, you know. Then that's really, really exciting. But I mean, no matter when it happens, it's always an honor, and it's cool to watch people, you know, like making out to my music in a scene. Or like, I remember once I saw this like really romantic, like sort of sex scene on the beach, you know, in the sand. It was really funny. You know, or sometimes people are being very dramatic and they're breaking up or something like that. I don't know. But it's always fun to see what happens with the music at the same time.
And what happens with your audience when they listen to your music, for instance, on live shows? Do they also start to kiss?
They cuddle. I once had, I played a show in Los Angeles where two different people fainted across the room from each other. It wasn't because they were like really excited to see me. It was because one of them hadn't eaten, and I think that the other one maybe just wasn't feeling well. I don't know, but it was really.
But it was not because of your music.
I don't think so. I hope not. But it was an unfortunate situation. But yes, there's a lot of cuddling at my shows. A lot of people come with their boyfriends or girlfriends, and maybe they kiss or hold hands. It's nice.
So you still keep watching them. So you see what's happening in front of the stage.
Yeah, and then I tell them to get a room. No, I'm just kidding. I love it. I think it's wonderful.
yeah, maybe tonight also. We will have some couples who are cuddling, not fainting.
Yes, hopefully not fainting. Or cuddling and then fainting together at the same time. That would be nice.
This would be romantic.
Yes.
Almost as romantic as our interview here next to the fireside.
I know. Should we hold hands?
Rosie.
Gaze into each other's eyes.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Roxy, for
having me. Thank you for the nice interview. Have a wonderful show tonight.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So, das war die wunderbare, zauberhafte Rosie Golan. Wir schalten nochmal zurück zum Konzert für die letzten paar Lieder. Viel Spaß damit. Und vielleicht habt ihr ja gerade neben euch jemand auf der Couch, mit dem ihr auch kuscheln könnt und knuddeln könnt.
Oh,
tut das.
Like this.
Tut das genauso wie wir jetzt gerade. Tschüss.
Tschüss.
I'm getting undressed in front of you as we speak, apparently.
Last night you came, I felt you breezing by. I don't know if you're real or just my mind playing tricks at night. Oh, I'm seeing Cause I don't know where I begin, don't know where I'm gonna end today. And oh, I feel just like a child running around getting wild, don't know where of the time. And I'm walking around this town, I'm looking up, I'm looking down, I'm singing, singing out. I don't wanna wait, I don't. Restaurants, the foreign tongue, the ambiance they gave. A day, a week, a month, it seems, always running out of steam and lead. See it all passing me.